justifiably wrong, and they're trying to make us illegal. They're going to make us nowhere to live, nowhere to party, nothing to do. They want us to disappear off the face of the earth, and it's wrong.
To celebrate our multicultural society, to celebrate our right to free assembly, and to celebrate our right to party.
First they came for the travellers. I wasn't a traveller and I didn't speak out. Then they came for the ravers and the partiers, and I wasn't a raver or a partier and I didn't speak out. And then they came for me and there was nobody left to speak out for me.
When tyranny is abroad, submission is a crime. Submission is a crime. You have a duty to resist this bill.
An event you didn't see on television news. Last month, thousands of people danced through the streets of London to demonstrate against the introduction of the Criminal Justice Bill. This new legislation, scheduled to come into effect in July, will give police and local authorities new powers against so-called raves and free music festivals. Section 5 of the Criminal Justice Bill, the measures that affect the free party and festival scene. The police will have powers to end raves or outdoor festivals. It will be a criminal offence to disobey the direction to leave one.
Basically, Chris, you're a journalist.
Yeah.
You're a cook.
She's a cook.
Three people, I'm a barman. Three people who have totally different ideas on life, and what we're doing, we're standing in a field and we're having a good time.
A rave will be defined as a gathering of 10 people or more listening to amplified music. The Criminal Justice Bill refers to sounds wholly or predominantly characterised by the emission of a succession of repetitive beats. For thousands of years, people have been dancing to tribal rhythms. Modern dance music is the electronic descendant of this form.
Tell them what fun we're having.
I'm having quite a lot of fun. This man's obviously having loads of fun. He's got his wishes, I'm telling you.
The police will have the power to stop people whom they believe to be proceeding to an outdoor party or festival anywhere within a 5-mile boundary of the site.
Have you seen
your civil rights?
The courts will be empowered to order the forfeiture of equipment, including vehicles, seized at outdoor raves. Section 5 of the Criminal Justice Bill is not just aimed at curbing parties and festivals. It also introduces criminal provisions against a whole range of other groups, including travellers, squatters, and those involved in peaceful protest.
All government is wrong.
The real problem being in this country that there's no constitution, there's no Bill of Rights, there's no backstop which prevents governments from continuously eroding the rights that people have. Part of me is amazed that they should proceed with such draconian legislation. The purpose is to criminalise whole parts of the community. It is in purpose exclusive. What the government need, I think, is an enemy within. They want a target group, and they want to appear to be tough in relation to law and order. The result will be that they will spend vast amounts of money policing the activities of people which have hitherto probably been lawful.
really came out of the mind of Michael Howard, the current Home Secretary. And it's a collection of prejudices, really, a collection of saloon, you know, it's as if he went to the saloon bar door, threw it open and said, what do you think we should do about criminals? And people in groups in society we don't like very much. And he simply wrote down this collected farrago of prejudice and misinformation in one piece of legislation, which, as it stands, is probably the broadest, most comprehensive attack on civil liberties in this country since the Second World War. So it's a very serious act to try and get through Parliament.
We're inside a cave that's a natural cave. It's really lovely, it's just like the Flintstones, and they're doing a rave in the cave. This is what they reckon on the criminal justice bill.
These sort of parties, you can go in your jeans, your trainers, you can dance all night, the people are friendly, there's no fighting, there's no trouble, everybody's just happy, and that's the way the world should be. You gotta fight for your right to party.
I think this is the best party I have been to for a long time, that's just got
good,
honest
good.
Truth.
I mean, it's
really excellent.
Shows, there's still a demand for it. As many people as are going to clubs and that every weekend. Mm. I mean, you see for yourself, the atmosphere up there is unrivaled. You know?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Police have been curbing free parties and festivals for a number of years.
Oh dear.
Section 5 of the Criminal Justice Bill can be seen as a consolidation of existing police activity.
Every time they've come so far, we've like sorted it out really. They've just said, okay, carry on, you know. I think they realise it's a little bit bigger this time.
A farmer's field, he doesn't want his land trashed.
Not only that, you're causing obstruction of vehicles parked up the road. If you start parking along here, they'll be causing obstruction as well.
Who are the organisers? Do you know the...
The name is Extra Pleasure.
Extra Pleasure?
What they're seeking to do is pass a law which will have phenomenally draconian powers placed in the hands of police to stop people going to parties, taking their equipment to parties, travelling within 5 miles of a party. And provisions in this bill will give the police fresh discretionary powers. So they'll be able to walk up to somebody and say, I want you to leave this land. And if you say why, in other words, you refuse to immediately comply, you could be arrested and charged with a criminal offence.
What's your name, please?
Do I have to give you a name?
Yeah.
I do.
Yeah, please.
Some of the historic safeguards we've had in our criminal justice system, such as the right to remain silent, they're also being taken away in this bill. Yeah.
What's your full address, Caroline?
Do you know they're dangerous in case?
There are fresh powers of stop and search within the bill which will give the police really considerable discretion to hold someone for a long period of time simply because they've been found in the vicinity of a specified location. Now, this is not the solution.
We've not had a lot of trouble from the police tonight. I mean, basically, they just want to make sure the roads are clear, which we do. Mm. We keep the parking, you know, control. We make sure everyone's not stupid. But say, in terms of events, if the Criminal Justice Bill comes in, we've got no chance.
Mm. Because in fact, the police won't have much room to manoeuvre themselves. I mean, here they might be playing low profile for whatever reason, but the bill doesn't give them much scope for doing that.
I'm not doing anybody any harm, and I don't see how they could possibly complain about this one, really.
These people are going to be made criminals because they are actually organising themselves into doing these sorts of activities. It's this sort of initiative that's being so firmly squashed and stamped on. I mean, it just seems ridiculous to me. And that's why, one of the reasons why I'm so centrally involved with this particular campaign, and I think it's really, really important. End.
A sound system prepares for a party from scratch, making backdrops, building equipment and practicing their music. The Free Party Network offers many groups of people the opportunity to get involved creatively. This is particularly significant in the lives of unemployed people.
Have a seat.
Please.
I'm drawing out the backdrop in charcoal, one of the banners.
The IP sound system supports advanced party banner.
This is called a conspiracy.
This is a conspiracy
to play music.
A potential breach of the peace.
We've all been arrested for it. We've had our equipment confiscated for it. We've had our rights. We've had our rights taken away from us, basically, by the people that are supposed to protect us, which is absolute rubbish. Mm. But we still do it, and we are still going to hopefully continue to do it.
Well, this is the drawings that we've done for the speakers.
Have you done one of these before, then?
Yeah, a bit, not a great
not
deal.
Much.
I didn't learn.
Yeah,
it's just basically I've learned from basically doing it just by myself.
Yeah. When the parties get stopped, what do you feel then?
There was no reason for that. Mm. Especially when people get arrested and get put in police cells for hours and hours and hours and then just let out, oh no, actually, we don't want to charge you.
The majority of people in the mainstream cannot understand that we do things for this.
That's the first question.
Yeah. Smile, yeah. Happiness.
That's the first question anyone happiness. Is associated with it.
Seeing 500,000 people running around in a field, in a warehouse, whatever, really having such a blast that something that we helped to set up, it's just such a laugh. That is the buzz that we get.
I was born here, mate. Born in this country, so I'm an Englishman, so I know what's going on out there, and I don't agree with it. No. They're pulling the wool over a lot of people's eyes, and unfortunately, they're not prepared to even listen or see what is going on. As it always goes.
I never thought that I'd be involved politically or trying to fight a new piece of legislation. I was just having some fun with some mates, putting on a party for other people. And now, here I am, organising, taking part in helping out with the Advanced Party and what it stands for.
One of the things that really used to attack the party network is drugs. What do you feel about that?
We're not there to organise a drug party. Mm. We're there to organise a party. We can't stop people coming there and taking a drug before they even get there or while they're there. I'm not going to go up to someone and say, oh, get out of your mouth.
Release is an organisation that works with drug users and their families.
It's certainly the case that drug use is associated in various ways with that kind of culture and that kind of scene, but it doesn't equal the same thing. There are many people who will go to raves, go to outdoor events, go to pop festivals and all the rest of it, who won't use drugs. And it is certainly not something that is limited to the party scene, to the dance drug scene at all. It's going on in all kinds of environments. Perhaps one that I would mention, which doesn't get a lot of publicity, but it is well accepted and recognised that many people who go to football matches have indulged in various kinds of recreational drugs. Well, most of the people who are involved in these events that we've come into contact with from the party scene actually take a fairly responsible line, and they are developing themselves various codes of conduct and code of good practice in order to deal with any drug-related problems that they encounter. And that's the way that we should be dealing with it, not trying to take a blanket just say no kind of position, or don't run these events at all, because all we will be doing is pushing the problem elsewhere. At the moment, we have, if you like, a captive audience of people who can be educated about sensible harm reduction and drug prevention measures, and we should be using that as an opportunity, not trying to put those people elsewhere in places they will be marginalised and where we're not going to be able to get these kind of messages to them.
We are out there to
supply them with drugs. We supply them with music,
fun,
camouflage, lights, visual effect, a good party effect. That's it. And my stunning
Harry. Sound systems like Oops have often had problems finding sites for their parties. The aim is to cause minimum disruption to the public who have been justifiably concerned about these events. One group of party organisers in Buckinghamshire found what they thought was the perfect site, a wood formerly used for paintball combat.
We sent out invitations trying to get together friends and colleagues to organise a party, a festival in these woods, miles away from anywhere, with the consent of the landowner, which was a rare opportunity. There's about 60 acres of woodland here, numerous clearings, plenty of space, plenty of noise-deadening trees, no residents for miles, and yet it still didn't happen.
Well, this is it.
Still makes me feel very sad.
Yeah.
The sort of potential that's down.
And this is what all the police resources went to stop us coming in here.
So you cannot hear. I mean, we're totally enclosed by the wood now. Mm. Nobody would have been able to hear us, nobody would have been able to see us.
A police vehicle with dogs arrived. We then said to them where we would leave the land, and we packed up our stuff and we're ready to drive away and go home. And then at that point, the police decided that it wasn't good enough for them, so they arrested us for some obnoxious reason. I mean, conspiring to cause a public nuisance, whatever.
Yeah. They actually said to us, they said that you had the potential to breach the peace, yeah, and therefore we will arrest you.
The charges were eventually dropped.
I think people have got to know what is actually happening. It's not just a matter that people just go out and set a sound system up and just have a party in the middle of nowhere with no consideration for anybody.
We do try and keep it away from people, away from farm animals, that kind of thing. I mean, we actually had posters everywhere saying, please take your rubbish home. We had got loads of black bags
Beans
and everything,
everything
in to collect all the rubbish. We'd said to people, don't let your dogs roam free, don't use fences for firewood, all this kind of thing. We really do think an awful lot about the effect it's going to have. And in fact, we tend to leave most places tidier than they were before. And it was the straw that broke the camel's back, this party, because we felt we'd done it the right way, and they weren't letting us continue
anyway,
whatever way we did
it.
And that's where the advance party came from.
Yeah.
I mean, we actually sat down and thought,
Enough's enough.
The bill will only outlaw free or unlicensed parties and festivals. However, one police authority has already said there will be no raves in their county, legal or otherwise. For us in the advance party, the costs of a licensed event are prohibitive. The essence of the free parties and festivals is that anyone can go, not just those who can afford high ticket prices. This mix of people produces the special atmosphere of the scene. One group of people particularly significant in producing this feeling are the travelling community. For thousands of years, festivals have been the opportunity for the settled community and the travelling community to get to know each other. Today, youth travellers going to parties support themselves and their families by selling refreshments and entertaining with their skills.
Romany travellers, gypsies, I mean, it's part of this country. National heritage. And I'm not a gypsy.
Yeah.
Travellers will not only be affected by those parts of the bill that curb festivals. The bill contains specific measures aimed directly at their way of life.
I think it's sick. The criminal trespass bill is sick as well. Because it's just mass oppression, isn't it, really?
We are constantly reminded about Germany in the 1930s, about fascism. What we have to remind people is that the first people who went to the wall in Germany were the travellers. There are very few German gypsies left.
You're taught from an early age that you live in a free liberal democracy. This is the freest country in the world. And suddenly when you grow up and make a decision on how you want to live your life, it's not free.
I served in the Royal Navy. My job was to prevent the Russians from taking away our freedom, in inverted commas. The only person, or the only people who are trying to take away my freedom, it's the British government, it's John Major. And, like, all those years spent in the Navy are a waste of time, basically.
So what do you think will happen
if the Criminal Justice Bill comes in and becomes a law, and then all of a sudden you're going to be criminals for doing what you do.
We'll get hounded from county to county, and the last county we'll be in will be the one with the most humane chief constable.
It will be a criminal offence when more than six vehicles are together on a piece of land not to leave when ordered to do so by a police officer. The Criminal Justice Bill refers to gypsies and defines them as persons of a nomadic habit of life, whatever their race or origin. These measures are therefore an attack upon all travellers, traditional and otherwise.
On the one hand, the government is saying we're going to take away from local authorities the obligation to provide sites. But on the other hand, they're going to increase the criminal penalties that will apply to travellers who occupy land unlawfully. That is not a coherent government policy. That is simply the enactment of a prejudice.
Human societies began with travellers. Travellers are part of our history and our heritage, as well as our future. You're all the children of travellers.
3 gatherings and festivals have been part of our culture for thousands of years.
Why can't we have a party here if it's been going for 5,000 years?
Tan Hill in Wiltshire, an ancient festival site of pre-Christian spiritual significance. No one lives here but the ghosts of the past. Tan is the Celtic word for fire. Ian Donald lives locally. He's researched the history of the hill.
This festival on Tan Hill had a tradition going back thousands of years, and it was a continuous tradition right up until about 60 years ago. It's so ingrained in our history. The Criminal Justice Bill is going to basically criminalise people who want to indulge in festivals, and just to go and gather and enjoy yourself and continue that tradition that was partaken by all members of the community, gypsy and landowner alike. Nobody is born with any more rights, in my opinion, to the land than anybody else. It's everybody's land, and to say that you are a criminal if you go to a... Say you go up to Tan Hill on August the 5th or 6th to sort of, you know, sit by the campfire and play some music with your friends, and you could be put in prison for that for 6 months or something. Doing something that's been done for thousands of years, it's just, to me, is quite sad and insane, really.
At some large festivals, there was disruption to local communities, and there was some justifiable and legitimate public concern amongst people who didn't really want to have, you know, 20,000 people on their doorstep without them being asked first, any more than any one of us would. So the government was required, really, to make some kind of imaginative response. Now, there were perfectly happy and well-organised free festivals at Stonehenge, for example, up until the mid-1980s, and they were suddenly banned.
This place should be open to the public on Midsummer's Day and all spiritual occasions, like the equinoxes and the two solstices. It's a very important spiritual place for this planet. Every Midsummer's, there was always this 1,000 locals that would turn up and hang out, usually after the pubs, you know, come out and watch the druids and all that, you know. Eventually it got so big, I think the government started thinking, oh my God, this is getting massive. What can we do? Stop it.
There really is some obligation on the government to identify some of the large areas of derelict land to provide alternative sites for festivals. You know, the hardcore areas on airfield, disused airfields in southern England, for example, of which there are many, many amounts. Now, the government will say, well, we don't want to have or encourage large events that cause disruption. Well, there's a real hypocrisy here, because when the Henley Regatta takes place, or Brands Hatch motor racing, and most large sporting and cultural events, there is very substantial disruption to the life of the community. The government cannot legislate people's rights to enjoy themselves out of existence.
Little Salisbury Hill, an ancient fort on the outskirts of Bath.
And apparently it was a festival site for thousands of years, and lots of people around the area would like to have their own festivals on different hills, and you could make contact with fire right across the whole of England, virtually, possibly even Britain.
This site has double importance in the context of the fight against the Criminal Justice Bill. A new bypass around Bath is cutting into the side of the hill. Road protesters have been attempting to stop construction.
They keep telling us that festival people make mess and that we're the ones that cause the damage.
This type of peaceful protest relies on methods of mass trespass and ancient squatting rights. Currently, this type of action is subject to civil law and is regarded as a dispute between parties to be settled in court without recourse to police intervention. Under the new bill, protesters involved in these actions will be subject to the criminal law and liable to police arrest, fines, and imprisonment. So will party and festival goers, squatters, travellers, in fact, all people who will not or cannot conform to the government's particular view of society.
Why has, then, the government declared war on so many people? And they should not be criminalised!
From diverse patterns of life, we learn new things about ourselves. Whereas a society that's homogenous, where uniformity is imposed, that is a society that has ceased to be able to learn about itself and ceases to be able to grow. This will not be a successful society.
Having a law and having the ability to enforce that law are two quite separate things. If people peacefully oppose the key provisions of the bill, I think we can create a situation where the authorities really don't feel able to implement some of the more draconian aspects of the bill. So I would not give up, and I would urge others not to give up, simply because the bill becomes law, because there is a long way to go.
Travellers are not the problem! Ravers aren't the problem! It's the government that's the problem! When tyranny is abroad, submission is a crime! Submission is a crime. You have a duty to resist this bill.
There may be trouble ahead, but while there's moonlight and music and love and romance, let's face the music and dance. Before the fiddlers have fled, before they ask us to pay the bill, and while we still have the chance, let's face the music.